What year is this?
2000.
Yep.
2009-5 Aero.
Looks pretty good for a 20-plus-year-old car. Factory paint or...?
Factory paint. A little bit faded.
Yeah.
But I think it adds to the look of it. Got the baby seat. It's a proper sleeper.
I like the wheels.
Yeah.
Tri-spokes are always a bit funny, but they did a pretty good job on them.
Yeah, the car looks pretty good. Back in the day, these would have looked like a pretty good car. I wouldn't have been able to afford it, that's for sure.
Yeah, I reckon. How did you end up with the Saab, though? Like,
I'm an Alpha guy, believe it or not.
Yeah.
My mechanic work on Alphas. Yeah. And I've done everything there is to do.
Yeah.
And I thought, what's left? Let's go for a Saab.
Let's go for a Saab.
Cheap power.
You know, if you get on car sales and type in turbo, say, 150 plus kilowatts, right? The first five cars will be Saab.
This is factory E85.
Yeah,
bio really? Power, yeah. So I can run petrol or E85. Air-conditioned seats, heated seats. It's magic.
So these are...
Rides like a boat.
These were like a 2.3, were they?
2.3 turbo.
Yeah.
Yeah. Goes pretty good.
And is this like some of the older Saabs with a gearbox? Oh, no, it's different.
No, this is conventional.
This is conventional.
So this one is a 4-speed auto. They come in manual, but it's pretty rare. The later ones come in 5-speed auto.
Mm-hmm.
But the 4-speed auto is really nice because once it gets on boost, it just loads up the turbo and it lifts up the front wheels and it just pulls like a jet. It's pretty good. I'm building another one at the moment as well.
Yeah.
I'm doing a 9000, an earlier one before this, manual.
That's a big engine mount sort of.
Yeah, yeah. You can see the little turbo there, little TD04.
Yeah.
Similar to what's on a WRX, but bigger. Yep. It's a TD04 19T.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they float a bit more, didn't they?
Yeah. It's pretty much the biggest of the TD04s you're going to get. Yep.
So what power were these rated to engine-wise stock?
Standard, they were rated at 169 kilowatt. And then the year after, Saab rated them at 190.
Mm-hmm.
There was no changes. It was just because it was an overboost, from what I understand.
Yeah.
This has got a fair bit more than that. It's all in the standard thing, but it runs about 200 kilowatt the wheels.
The Series 2 always magically ends up with a bunch more power and they do nothing.
Yeah, really. I know.
This is a 20-year-old car. You can put E85 in it.
It was technically 2002 or something like that. But I've just put the software from the later one.
Yeah.
My tuner has his over here.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
It has a flex fuel type sensor in it, does it?
No, it does it all via the O2 sensor.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So the O2 sensor, from what I understand, you tune it on fuel and you tune it on E85, and then it knows what the two...
A lot of the newer cars do that, don't they?
Yep. And it uses the O2 sensor. And even when you fill up, it comes up on the dash, tells you the percentage.
Wow.
All as per... factory.
That's awesome.
I mean, what are you going to buy for a couple of grand that does that? There's absolutely nothing. So with this, I can see that's air temperature, engine temperature. It's got like an onboard ECU ignition offset. And I'll tell you something else. The little wipers at the front work.
They do work.
Yeah, they never work. These are, they work. So how cool is that?
With winter just around the corner, what better time to get yourself some Foolbost merch? And we've got these great new sweatshirts in a bunch of different designs. So get to them at shop.foolboost.com.au.